Lisa was a young girl who was adopted by a wealthy New York family, and at age 17 she fell in love with a member of a motorcycle gang named John. This man was her opposite in literally every way, but they say opposites attract, and Lisa became obsessed with getting him to fall in love with her. After many failed attempts, she thought of turning to witchcraft to get him to fall in love with her, but she ignored all warnings and then ignored all safety procedures to keep herself safe from spiritual harm. As she was performing the ritual, an entity made its presence known to her. She could hear it whisper in her ear, "You're mine, Lisa, all mine. Remember your promise, Lisa." She would hear this whenever she felt the entity near, and soon the entity was around her almost all day and all night. Slowly, Lisa became a completely different person. John did fall in love with her, but she wasn't as attracted to him as she thought she would be, and she started suffering from mood swings, fits of rage, high fevers, and anytime she tried to get rid of the entity, it would attack her violently. At age 18, Lisa's friend Stan took her to meet Ed and Lorraine Warren, and right away the Warrens picked up on the negative entity that was controlling her. During a discussion with Ed Warren, the entity made its presence known to Lisa and told her that it would cut her tongue out and throw her into the Sea of Oblivion, and if she wanted the attacks to stop, she had to kill Stan for bringing her to the Warrens. Ed made the entity leave and continued to interview Lisa. Lisa and Stan stayed the night at the Warrens' house, and Lisa decided that she was going to fight the demon and renounce her satanic worship that she now found herself a slave to. On the way back to their college, Lisa experienced something brand new. While in the car, she got a sharp pain across her chest that made it almost impossible to breathe, and she could hear voices in her head. The pain and voices lasted a few minutes and then went away. That night, a black cloud appeared next to her bed, and she could hear her own voice coming from within the cloud saying, "Hear me, for I am thine, thy own humble servant, thy own daughter, Lisa." Over the next few months, she started seeing and hearing less of the entity, and she assumed the ordeal was over, but one day she got those stabbing pains in her chest again, and she started having visions of her killing Stan with a knife. She went to the school nurse, but they couldn't find a cause for the pains. Over the next week, dark circles started appearing under her eyes, and she started getting really violent around Stan. So every time that she would be in a room with Stan, she'd start having these fits of rage, she would excuse herself or run out of the room. This caused her to become a bit of a recluse around her friends. Finally, one night, she had enough of all of this, and she threw out and destroyed all of her occult and ritual items, and she vowed to never think about what had happened ever again. As time went on, she heard less and less of the negative entity, but she still saw it every once in a while. Meanwhile, Stan started having violent dreams of killing his parents, and he started seeing dark figures in his house. Lisa never fully got rid of the demon, but she was able to stop it from completely destroying her life. Now, this is a very interesting Warren's case for me because, for one, it was never fully resolved. When you look at a lot of their cases, there was a semi-happy ending. And, you know, it's not the happiest ending, but in most cases, they were able to help the family and get rid of the entities. But in this case, they didn't. This was one of those few that they were not able to completely get rid of it. And Lisa still, for the rest of her life, went on seeing this entity. And information about this case is not very well known. I got this information off a few articles, and then there is a book, Deliver Us From Evil, very good book, about some of the lesser known Ed and Lorraine Warren cases, and this is one of the main cases that are highlighted in the book. So, what do you all think about the Satan's Daughter case? Do you believe it? Do you think it's a hoax? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. Hope you all enjoy this video. Leave a like if you did. I'm Jake from Fife Paranormal. Have a great day, everyone.